Okay, so hello everybody. Thank you for tuning in. Today we have a amazing study on the Greek and Hebrew words, and today we will be focusing on one a beautiful Hebrew word. Now, when we study Greek and Hebrew, we have to understand one thing. Just simplify. How to simplify our thinking about these languages, these biblical languages. Well, let's think about the Greek language as a language of science, the medicine, the doctors, a very precise language, the language of a lawyers, the judge and so on, very precise definitions. On the other hand, the Hebrew, the Old Testament language of the Bible, we have to think about it a little bit differently. We have to understand the mindset of those people. And we could say that the Hebrew language is a picture language. And it speaks very much to our emotions. It's carrying, certain impression and communicates to us some truth, in this like vivid way of painting, certain scene for us, certain scenario. So, for example, I wanted to look today at this one verse in a book of Psalms 51. And this is the story of David after he sinned with Bathsheba, and he's saying these words in Psalm 51, verse 1. Have mercy upon me, O God, according to your loving kindness, according unto the multitude of your tender mercies, blot out my transgression. So in this one verse, we see these words: Have mercy upon me, O God, according to your loving kindness, and then according to multitude of your tender mercies. Now, when you study the scripture, Old Testament, look at the original languages always, because, for example, here we are using King James Version, and you see these translations: mercy, loving kindness, and mercies. And many times, the translators they interchanged the translation, the meaning of these words. So let's have a look, because today I want to look at the word racham, speaking about mercy and forgiveness. But now it starts here: have mercy upon me. Here is another word. This word used here is a chesed, or even chesed. Later on, hanan. That's the root from which it's coming. By the way, we have this Psalm 51 behind me. So have mercy. Now this word chesed means literally to bow your neck. So what he says here, you could say have mercy. The proper translation would be like, be kind unto me, show me your kindness, or, and we are getting there, show me your grace. What it means. Bow your neck, bow down, notice me, notice my case. I'm calling unto you out of distress, and I'm just asking, please just look down. You can have this even when you are honoring somebody. You meet somebody and you want to show him a kindness. A woman is entering a room, so you open the door and you bow your head. You are not looking to her eye proudly, you just like honor her. You look on the ground and like, please enter. So there's this kindness. You are showing that you are kind. You are showing your love. So keep this in mind, that it has this beautiful meaning. So notice my case. Bow down, look upon me, O God, according to your loving kindness. Now, this second word, which is chesed again, or hanan, this is translated very well: loving kindness. Now it's there, it's a grace, many times translated as loving kindness. That's what we said, you know, show me your kindness, which is rooted in your love, you know, that you bow, you know, that you bend, in this case the neck, like that you notice me, you know, that you see my case. And then now we are getting into the word that we want to speak about today, according to the multitude of your tender mercies. You know, beautiful translation, tender mercies. You know, this Hebrew word, rechem or recham, rechem, many times translated, have a compassion upon me. Be compassionate, have mercies upon me. And we all understand this, you know, have mercy upon me, forgive me, you know, give me forgiveness. The definition of a grace is give me something I don't deserve. And mercy means take away the judgment that I do deserve, or don't give me what I deserve. That's why this grace, kindness, chesed, is to bow down, notice me. I don't even deserve that you would notice me. You know, me, sinner, warm, but please, you know, from your love, notice me, give me this notice, give me your grace, you know, come into my situation. And then this tender mercies and blot out my transgression. You see, there's this beautiful connection. Blotting out in this case means to smooth it out, like if you would use oil, you know, and you are brushing something with the oil and you smooth it, you make it smooth, you know, you take it away. Polishing, basically, we could say there is a wound and you polish it and it's taken away. Blotted out, you know, that it's not visible anymore. And this word for mercies, mercy, rechem. Now the original meaning, you know, is a womb, you know, a mother's belly, where she carries a baby. It's a womb, you know, mother's belly, womb. So now we are getting to full picture, you know, make a pause and think about it. The mother's womb. So he's praying and he says, God, bow your neck. Give me grace, like notice me. I don't even deserve it. Please come into my case. You know, give me your loving grace. And now, according to your tender womb, blot out my transgression, you know. We could say, forgive me. But now, this is the point, you know. Forgiveness is not, as we have been taught many times in a school of Western thought. Forgiveness is, oh, okay, I forgive you, and it's okay. I don't want to even see you, maybe, you know. No, this forgiveness means something else. It means a womb. You know, what's womb? You know, you carry a baby there. You give him nutrition. You give him protection. That's the mother's womb. And this is the mercies. You know, God, when he grants his mercy, when God gives forgiveness in the understanding of these words in the Old Testament, he not only says it's forgiven, it's gone, it's been blotted out, there is no memory of it, but he is fonding you, you know, he's carrying you like a baby, you know, he gives you what you need. So forgiveness in this case is not just I take away your sin, but I take away your sin and you are accepted, you are forgiven. You know, forgiven means you are accepted, you've been received, you are mine, you are now protected, I will nurture you, I will love you, I will protect you, I will keep you like in my womb, you know, now you are mine and I'm yours and I will take care of you. You know, adoption. This is beautiful, it's so rich and powerful. You know, please continue with the studies of Greek and Hebrew words with us. Because as you see, we are getting these rich meanings, you know. If you think only like, God, give me grace and forgive me my sin, it's beautiful. But if you go deeper and you see this meaning, you know, God, bow your neck, notice me, give me something I don't even deserve. Give me your loving kindness and then forgive me in a sense, Take it away and receive me, and now nurture me, because I've been hurt in my sin. I'm hurting, I'm wounded, and you are the loving Father who takes you into his everlasting arms, and he carries you through this season of this horrible difficulties in the soul of King David after he sinned with Bathsheba. So this is the beautiful word. Remember, you know, chesed, grace or loving kindness, and the root is to bow your neck, and mercy or forgiveness, forgive, grant mercy, meaning take away, blot out my sin, let not there be even memory, and even more, it's a womb, you know, rechem, Hebrew word rechem, it's a womb. Carry me, protect me now, nurture me, you know, beautifully, you know, take care of me as a baby, you know, so rich, so rich. So next time, you know, when we think about these words in our practical life, you know, when you fail and you ask God for grace and mercy, this is what it means, you know. He will not cast you away. You know, Hebrews 13:5, he will never leave you nor forsake you. He is there for us, and this is his heart revealed in the scripture. So, thank you for the studies of mercy and forgiveness. God bless you. Amen.